if you like to know how I made this from this, then stay tuned.
Share, comment, subscribe, like, or dislike to my channel, please. Share, comment, subscribe, like, or dislike to my channel, please. Don't forget to hit the bell because you will never know when I come out with another video. Share, comment, subscribe, like, or dislike to my channel, please. Share, comment, subscribe, like, or dislike to my channel, please. Don't forget to hit the bell because you will never know when I come out with another video. Don't forget to hit the bell because you will never know when I come out with another video. Please share, comment.
Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be doing a video showing you how I built this end table, small bookshelf, whatever you want to use it for. I'm going to be using it as an end table. I'm going to show you how I'm going to build it. First, I'm going to show you what I've done first. See, what I did was, I got a bookshelf and I cut down the wood to the length and width that I need. This is going to be the bottom. And see, I put some plywood on the, I'm going to put plywood on all, over all the whole thing. But first I start off putting plywood over it to start off. This is going to be the bottom. And I make this one longer than all the rest of them. So when I add the pieces to it or put the sides on, the plywood can be flush to this piece right here from each side, including the back. So what I do is this is going to be the side, and from the side, I leave a piece of gap right here on each side, from the top, this side, and this side. I leave a gap, so when I have it on here like this, bump, this is going to be the inside, so it's going to be flush like this, but no. I'm going to show you from this way, but this is not going to be the way it's going to be. It's going to be flush like this. And so, once I add the plywood on the bottom of it, it's going to blend into this, flush to this piece right here. But no, this is the inside. I'm just showing y'all, demonstrating to y'all how it's going to look. This is how it should look. I have it just like this, each both sides, and it should look just like this. And then once you put the plywood on the bottom of this, it should get flush to this. So now, I'm about to get started. I don't think so. No, 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 no. I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. I don't think so. No, 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 no. I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. I don't think so. No, 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 no. Maybe someday you'll have it your way. You always have to add glue. This is the kind I use. Maybe someday it'll all work out.
don't have to use your finger if you don't want to. I choose to because it's a lot quicker and easier for me than trying to use a brush. And less messier. All you have to do is just wipe your finger off than trying to wash out brushes. Wipe it on first before I try to get it flush how I want it. Okay. Kind of difficult doing it by yourself. So, bear with me.
No, I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. I don't think so. No, 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 no. Maybe someday you'll have it your way. Maybe someday it'll all work out.
Sideways. Apologize in advance. I didn't realize my head was in the camera. What I was doing was I was trying to knock it back so I can get it flush so I can get ready to put some screws in it.
Try to get it flush as I can. Then I tighten it some more. Then I add some screws in it. These are the kind of screws I use. This is the side I'm using right here.
Maybe someday.
Those are the kind I'm using. you split it, don't worry about that part because you're gonna add a piece of wood right there anyway, so it's gonna cover that up. Try to get as many screws as you can. Put the mold to go in. Unless you have to take back out. Make sense, but what I meant about unless you had to take it back out, that means the ones that don't go all the way in, you had to take that one back out once the wood, once everything dry. But if they go all the way in, then you have to worry about taking those back out. Well, I keep looking because I'm trying to make sure it didn't go out the wood instead of in the wood. No, I'm just trying to make sure that it actually in the wood. Is this the bottom? And I'm not actually adding another piece of plywood on here. So those ones that don't go completely in, I'm not too much worried about those. I just take those out in the morning or whenever it dry, and that'll be okay because it's gonna be stuck because the rest of them gonna hold it in. Like I say, if you split out, don't too much worry about it because what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a piece of wood on here. I can just tear that off. I can just go and tear that off because I'm going to add another piece on here anyway. So, that don't really matter. So now, this is how it should look. Hold on, let me take these clamps off. Because it should be steady enough. Now, if you're working in the house, be careful because you will get glue on the floor. And if you do, make sure you get it up right before it dry. But I'm going to show y'all this before I try to get this glue up. See, this is how it should look. And because it's not completely dry yet. Now that's how it should look in here. You know, I can see that. So let me get this glue up. Now make sure you always get this extra glue up before it dry. Because it will give you problems later on. And see about this not being sandy. It's so easy to get up. Since I didn't sand it, basically the glue won't even stick. Once it dry, it just peel right off. So if you put plywood on it without sanding it, make sure you put a lot of staples or brand nails. I use brand nails, but if you want to use staples, you can. But make sure you put a lot of them because this glue, once it dry, it really won't even stick. It'll just peel right off. Okay, now we're gonna do the other side. The other side the same way as this side, or being this side. Then we're gonna do this side now. The same way. I'm gonna lay it down. So now I'm doing this side the same way. So I just got two pieces of wood to make it wide. So I just cut it to the width and the height I want it. This is how high it's gonna be. But I did two. Each one is two. You add the piece of plywood to make it steady. And if you don't want to do the plywood, you can add like the glue and sawdust in the middle of this. But you're going to have to wait until it dry. Then you add some wood filler. Then you sand it. But you're going to have to wait till it completely dry. If you don't want to do the plywood, you can do it that way. Just add the sawdust and the glue in the middle right here so it can stick together. Then you add the wood filler. Then you sand it, and then it should be one piece if you do it right. But you're going to have to sand. You're going to have to sand, because I already sanded this part. You're going to have to sand this so the glue can stick. Because if you don't, you'll be wasting your time, your money and everything, because it's not going to stick. It's just going to come right back apart because the glue is not going to stick to it. Whatever they got on this is pretty good because it doesn't stick to it. No paint, no glue, no nothing. I'm just wipe right back off. So you're going to have to sand it so the glue can stick. So let me put this piece on. careful so it won't fall. Try to get it flush. I'm hoping y'all can see that. Even if you split the wood, it don't matter. As long as it's not too bad. Like I said, as long as it's not too bad. Try to get as many screws as you can in here. Like I said, once you get through, make sure you get the extra glue up. I'm going to show you the back of it. Now, if you got something that didn't go completely in, since this is the bottom, it don't matter. Just let it sit there until it completely dry. Then the next day, you just take those out. Okay, now I'm gonna do the top. See, after you put the top on, you can leave it like this, or you can add inside shelves. That's what I'm going to do. What I usually do, I mark where the two pieces connected, like right here. I don't know if y'all can see that line. A knot right here. I forgot to put it on this side. So I'm hoping that I can get it flush. But I use a mark where the two connects it so I can know where to put it in. And see with the top, I do the inside first. This is going to be the inside, just like this. This, I mean, I be getting them mixed up. I think this is how I go. It's gonna go like this. And if you put the top on before these dry in place, a cure in place, then it'd be a lot easier. But I'm quite sure you probably know that. But I just wanted to mention that. But you do glue it. But if you want to, you can dry fit it and make sure that everything fit like it's supposed to. Then you add the glue. Then it screws. So that's what I usually do. I dry fit it first to make sure everything fit like it's supposed to before I add the glue. Because I hate to add the glue and then it don't fit like it's supposed to. Then now you gotta wipe that glue off before it dry and try to get it to where it fit like it's supposed to. So now let's get started. You do both sides together. I like to spread it out. If you put too much in, it will leak out, but it's okay because you can always wash that up before it dries. Try to get it flush. Don't go too far in, and the screws will fit better. But if you drill too far in, then the hole will be too big for the screw. It's okay if it's split though. Like I said, you're gonna always add. But that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add another piece of wood, but you don't have to if you don't want to. But you're gonna have to fix it. You can leave like that and just add some glue, wood fill, and sand it. I'm gonna let this sit for like a couple hours. Then I'm gonna take the ones out that didn't go completely in and gonna add the piece of plywood. Now, if it ain't flushing, you need to be able to hold it down to get a clamp. I think I should do this side first. Thank you. But right now, it just looked like a box. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add another piece inside of it. Okay, with the middle. I just add some wood, plywood on top. This is what it looks like. Yeah, I add a piece right here. This is the back. Now I'm gonna put this piece in. The back of it. Dry fit everything first. I put some bubble up underneath it so it can stay up. I dry fit it first. Then I add my glue. Then I get a clap, then I clap it down. Okay, now I'm finna do the back. I'm finna do the outside. I already did the inside. Now I'm about to do the outside. Now, if you got any screws that's sticking out as you was putting it together, now is the time to take those screws out. Okay, let's get started. Even though it's uneven, it's gonna be okay once you get through connecting all the woods together. You're not gonna be able to tell. But you shouldn't be able to tell.
I like to add a lot of glue. I go around the sides. Well, I go around the whole thing. The glue is everywhere. You know, it leaks out. You can just wipe that up later. If it leak out in the inside, make sure you get that up as soon as possible. Now this one I like to do a lot because just in case I don't get in nails or staples in it, the glue will still catch. And you just connect this piece to the bottom like this. Then you put, I like to make it longer so when I put the side on, it just connects to this.
I'm trying to make sure it caught on to the other side of the wood. Not inside, but caught on to the wood. So that's why I'm pulling it up. But even, you know, if I miss, I have to knock those out. You know the sides. You might not have to wipe the glue up because we're gonna add sides. Okay, now I'm about to do the sides. Already labeled. Thank you. okay, now I'm about to do the top. Okay, this is the last side. Now let me remind you again. If you got screws in that's sticking out or poking out from the inside, make sure you remove those screws before you add the top layer of wood. Because once you put that on there, you're not going to be able to move it. I'm quite sure you know that, but I just wanted to mention it. So let's get started. another reason why I removed the screws is because once I add this wood on it, it's gonna hold those other pieces that you're trying to get to glue together. It's gonna hold those pieces together. Okay, like I said at the beginning of the video, you don't have to add the outside layer of wood if you don't want to. All you have to do is just make sure that pieces are connected together. Make sure they are glued together really good. Then add some wood filler and wait till they cure dry enough, good enough. Then you sand it down. Not that it looked better, but this way is a lot easier for me. Because all you have to do is just fill in a little bit of gaps, if you have any. But if you cut the wood right, then you probably won't. Even though every piece of work you're going to have some type of gap. So now I'm going to put some pieces around the top. The side. Top side. Inside, make sure it's flush against the inside. Make sure it's not poking in or out or whatever you want to call it. Because if it is, remember you got to sand it. If it's not flush, you have to force it to be flush. Like this side right here. If the piece that you put on is shorter than the piece that you putting it on, make sure that the top part, like right here, is flush to this. Then you can leave a gap if you have another piece of wood to cover it. Then you can leave a gap, but if not, then make sure this piece is longer so it can come out some. At least an inch or two. Some come out just a little bit. So whenever you sand it, if you can sand it flush to it. So like this. This is shorter. So I'm gonna make it work. Now I just try to make this piece flush to this piece. and they're gonna leave a gap right here. So with that gap, I'm just gonna fill that in. And then when I sand this, it's gonna blend into this.
Okay.
Okay, this is how it looks. Look just like this.
Okay, I decided to show you this before I sand it down. This is why I put the wool fill on. I'm about to sand it down. It's the side of it. It's the other side. That's the back of it. Last but not least, one of the other sides.
okay, I'm only going to do this side on camera. I just want to show y'all how I do it. I stop at 220, but I'm going to stop at 80 right now because I got to flip it over and do the other sides. And once I finish all the sides, then I do all of them to 200. Then I start back at 1 or 120, and then I finish all of them till I get to 220. Or if I decide to go higher than that. But I just want to show y'all on camera how I sand these down. Now I'm going to sand the rest of them down, and I'll be back once I'm through and about ready to paint it.
Okay, finally through with it. I sand it, paint it. This is what it's looking like. I like this color. This is the front of it. I'm trying to hope you can see what's the top. But I turn around so y'all be able to see it. This is side. I know it's just plain. I was going to do like decoration, but you know, I'm in short of time. I got stuff to do, and I got other stuff to do. So I was trying to help get through with these so I can go and start on those. But I think it turned out all right. I like them. This the back. Okay, the bottom looks just like the top, so I ain't gonna show you the bottom. I put wheels on it, as you can tell. Both sides are the same. This the top again. So I'm gonna try to see, get it so y'all can see the inside. Like, see, that's what it looked like up in there. Okay, if you watch this video to the end, I appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.